From George and Bailey. Let's hear it.
We have a postcard from George, and it says, "Dear homecoming kids and Fritz, Bailey and I are having a wonderful time visiting this ranch. It's really beautiful, and there's horses and real cowboys. Bailey is still trying to make friends with the horses, since they're related, you know. Wish you all could be here, too. I miss your singing and your smiling faces. Love, George. P.S. Bailey writes, what do you call a sleeping bull?
Wiggly bull.
A bulldozer.
Wow, it must be great there.
Yeah.
I've never been on a ranch before.
Me neither.
It'd be great to wear a cowgirl outfit. I just love friends.
Yeah.
Why don't we all go visit George and Bailey right now?
Wow.
Taking into account all the aerodynamic theories combined with my own gravity cogitation, I am pleased to announce that this habitation is totally and proficiently capable of ascendancy into the atmosphere.
In English, Ricky?
I thought I described it most succinctly. The branch office can now fly. It's my own secret project that I've been working on.
Wow.
That gadget, listen, Einstein. I'm the flying expert around here, and I'm telling you, it isn't that easy. Trust me, there's no way we'll ever get yet.
What was that you were saying, Fritz?
Hold on, everybody!
Ricky, the Lord says, lo, I'm with you always.
Oh, sure. Flying is the easy part. But you know how to land this thing?
No problem, as long as there's a suitable tree.
Not for me, thanks. I'm flying the old-fashioned way, with wings. I'll see you at the ranch.
We're off to the west.
Yeah, it's really great. We always have so much fun singing and telling stories.
Uh-huh, we sure do. And the treehouse is really cool. And we tell all sorts of jokes.
It sure would be great to see them right now.
George?
And I miss having them around.
George?
Most of all, I miss the sound of their laughter. And I miss...
We gotta stop doing this. How in the world did you kids get here?
Don't ask. Just be glad there was a tree in the area.
Where's Fritz?
He's looking for you somewhere out there. He's saying no shortcut, but by now he's totally lost.
Yep, that sounds like my birdie buddy.
Hey guys, meet my new friend, Emily.
Hi, Emily!
Hi.
Look at this place. It's so big.
So wide.
I think I saw some real cowboys over there.
I'm looking forward to actual cowboy grub. When do we eat?
You know, I've always had a hankering to live out west and become a real cowgirl myself. Oh, the wide, wide west is the life for me. Nothing but sky as far as I can see. I'm a tumbleweed just a blowing.
Sing me off to sleep.
I can rope some doggies to earn my keep.
When my life is done, you can bury me. In the wide, wide west, pause the life for me. Ha ha, gotcha.
It's great you're all here. There's so much fun stuff to do. We've got a great cook, prairie to explore, and the security here makes it all real safe.
Well, I've got to go find Fritz. He gets so lost, he's probably headed for China by now.
Bye, Bailey.
Bye, Bailey.
Hey, can Nathan and I go see the horses over there?
Yeah, let's go.
Why don't the rest of you come in for a little refreshment? Turned you around.
Did you see that guy staring at us? Who do you think he is?
He looks really scary to me.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, just steer over here, partner.
Well, hello, Mr. Cowboy.
Hey, old kids.
My, what an outfit.
Yeah, it is.
Are you really a cowboy?
Well, of course I'm a cowboy. Name's Buddy. You don't think I'd be dressed like this if I weren't a cowboy? I do look like a cowboy, though.
Well,
I am a cowboy, at least for today. And to prove it, I'm just about to ride that horse.
Yeah, right.
Why would you want to ride that horse?
Have you ever ridden a horse before?
Why, sure, lots of times. I mean, several times. Well, okay, this is the first time, but hey, I've seen lots of westerns on TV.
I'd be scared.
Well, little lady, whenever I'm scared, I just remember that God is always with me. Just like he was with those good guys in the 10-gallon hats of the olden days. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
I don't think those guys wore cowboy hats.
And old King Nebuchadnezzar, he was the meanest, orneriest, sidewindingest, low-downest rascal that ever tried to do a fella in.
Well, there are lots of good stories in the Bible about courage.
Marched to the ocean, trapped, afraid, and didn't know what to do. God said, Moses, stretch out your staff. The waters opened up, and a nation marched right through. In my hand, whatever I'm facing, I'm sure to do it. If I trust the Lord, I'm sure to take the land. If I trust the Lord, I'm sure to take the land. Oh, if I trust the Lord, I'm sure to take the land. Oh, where the brakes on this thing?
Check him out. Let's go find the others.
Yeah, let's go. I know I shouldn't have taken that last turn, Pike. I don't even know what state I'm in. Man, this place goes on forever.
Now this is a great place for a telescope.
It'd be a good place for a set of stairs too. I'm way too over this.
I guess I forgot how big the world really is.
How did God make all this? It's so beautiful.
You think this place is awesome? Just think what heaven would be like.
That's right.
Jesus, I heard you had a big house where I would have a room of my own.
Jesus, we just want to tell you, we sure would like to go there.
Jesus, I heard that in your big house, there's plenty of love to go around. I heard there's always singing and laughter to fill the place with happy sound. And we've been thinking that a friend who planned to give us all that he's got, before we had even met him.
Well, he sure must love us a lot.
He really does, Mom. He sure must love us a lot.
You know what? Back at the chuck wagon, I saw this sort of, well, mysterious Indian-looking guy.
Long black hair and dark eyes, right?
Yeah. He's been watching us all day. I don't like it. I want the little kids to stay away from him.
Yeah.
He looks so scary to me.
True. Perhaps we should pursue his identity.
No, I think we should find out who he is first.
Good idea.
Oh, man, that was a clown.
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, hey, Johnson.
You want to work on the story for the roundup tonight?
Let's think. Oh, yeah, how about the Good Samaritan? Black in the Old West. You know, about the guy who's a rancher who gets robbed.
Mm-hmm.
Sure, Western counterparts for everybody.
Look, it's a hayride. Let's go.
Want to miss the hayride down to the creek. I'm sure Fritz will see me when he flies around.
Unless he crashed into a cactus or something.
Oh, I hadn't thought of that. Say, do you know why the cactus crossed the road?
No.
It was stuck to the chicken.
I never met the donkey who could talk before. You're funny.
Well, I come from a long line of talking donkeys. We go all the way back to Balaam's donkey, who saved his life.
How? Were they being chased by bad guys?
No, speed is not our strong point. Talking is.
Balaam was riding his donkey and was headed for a country called Moab, but God didn't want him to go. So God sent an angel with a big sword to block the way. Balaam didn't see the angel, but his wise little donkey did. So he turned and ran into a field, which made Balaam really mad, and he beat him. Well, back on the road, the angel stood in the way again. And again, Balaam didn't see it, but his wise little donkey did. This time, there was a wall on both sides of the road, so he tried to duck into the wall and crushed Balaam's foot. Balaam beat him again. Down the road a piece, the angel blocked the way a third time. But now, they were in a narrow gulch with no place to turn. Balaam didn't see the angel with the sword, but...
His wise little donkey did!
Right! So this time, he just fell down flat under Balaam. And Balaam beat him a third time. By now, my ancestor had just about had enough of this. He was just trying to help Balaam. So God allowed him to speak right up and tell Balaam the what for. Here you are, beating me 3 times, and you know I've never acted like this before. Maybe something is up, right? Which made Balaam stop and consider. Then God let Balaam see the angel, and boy was he surprised. The angel said how he had come to stop Balaam, and if this wise little donkey hadn't turned away those 3 times, he surely would have to kill Balaam. Yep, I don't mean to brag, but my ancestor was one
wise little donkey.
A great spot for a certain fish story I know.
I know a fish story too!
Jonah and the Whale!
Hey, you know what? Just so happens we know a song about that.
Old Jonah was a preacher, like some preachers of our day. No matter what the master said, he wanted things his way. Out on the raging waters, while running from the Lord, the ship was going under till they threw him overboard. Well, the whale did, yes, he did, the whale did annoy, did the whale did swatter old Jonah down. The whale did, yes, he did, the whale did annoy, did the whale did swatter old Jonah down. The whale did swatter old Jonah. The whale did swatter old Jonah down. Old Jonah started sinking, and surely he would drown. But God prepared a great fish and he swallowed Jonah down. Old Jonah started pleading in the belly of the whale. God heard Jonah praying and the Bible plainly tells.
Bad spit him up, yes he did, spit him up, I know he did, spit him up on some sandy land. Spit him up, yes he did, spit him up, I know he did, spit him up on some sandy land. Spit him up on some sandy. Spit him up on some sandy land.
Okay, kids, it's time to go. Let's go.
See a man, Jasmine?
He's gone now.
He's gone. Don't worry about it. I don't see a man. Do you, Emily?
So if you could just point me in a direction as the crow flies, you know? Look, have you seen a bunch of kids? How about a donkey? He's 5 feet tall. He's blue. Tells knock-knock jokes. You can't miss him. Nothing, huh? Can you hear me or what? Anyone home upstairs? Huh? Forget it.
Okay. I got one. What did the right eye say to the left eye? Just between you and me, something smells. Oh, I've got to find Fritz, but my feet are killing me.
Need some wheels?
Wow, wheels! What an idea! Now that's the way to travel! Vroom, vroom, wait for me!
Whoa! Those are some cool wheels!
Hey, I know where there's lots of them! Come on!
Wheels, wheels, we've got wheels.
clouds of dust. We're having fun. Hey, look at us!
Rolling, rolling, rolling with my real friends.
Paddle fast off.
Round and round and round they go.
Yee-haw!
We're on a roll.
Rolling, rolling, rolling with my real friends. Wheels, wheels, we've got wheels when all the chores are done. Wheels, wheels, go get your wheels. Round them up, head them up, move them out. Let's have some fun. One for the unicycle, two for the bicycle, three for the tricycle, four, there's more. Rolling, rolling, round and round. Pedal, pedal, faster, faster.
Hey, Emily, can you make it up that hill?
Sure, I'll take the wheelpower.
Well, where there's a wheel, there's a way.
Stay right there, little lady. I'm gonna help you out. You okay?
Is that better?
Uh-huh.
Let me see those knees.
Who are you?
Well, my name's Bill, but my people call me Birdsong. And I'm the foreman of this spread, and it's my job to make sure everything goes right and everyone's safe out here.
Really? We all thought, well, we were frightened of you.
You were frightened of me? Oh, I guess because I was always keeping an eye on you kids. You thought that I was different on the inside because of the way I looked on the outside. Emily, has that ever happened to you? Anybody look at you because you might be a little different to them? They might think differently of you on the inside?
All the time. I hate that.
Well, I reckon people ought to not judge a fellow by the way he looks on the outside, but take the time to take another look on the inside, because that's all God really cares about.
When you see someone who's different, just believe there's more than what you see. Could be that God looks at the heart and we should take another look. If you think that beauty's only just as deep as skin, then give it time. You'll find there's more than meets the eye when you
just take another look.
Walk in where many faces. What the outside hides reveals itself in inside places.
So take a chance on someone somewhere who not like you, and make some time to see what's going on inside. You need to take another look.
We all need to take another look.
You're very nice.
Well, thank you, sweetheart. I'm gonna make you an honorary member of my tribe.
Boy, did we ever make a mistake.
We're really sorry.
It's all right. There's probably not a lot of guys like me running around where you grew up. You know, if you look around us, we're surrounded by aspens. In a matter of weeks, they're gonna turn gold. Underneath the ground, the aspens, their roots are all tied together. They don't grow alone. They grow like a whole family. And I feel like I'm your brother, and you're my sisters and brothers, because, you know, a little while ago, a big old cowboy came up to me, and he brought me out in these mountains, and he told me about Jesus Christ. And I wouldn't be the same if I wouldn't have accepted the Lord into my heart. And now I know that God looks on the inside instead of the outside.
Will you be with us for the campfire tonight?
I'm gonna be really scared, unless you're there.
Sure, I wouldn't miss it.
Whoa!
Hey, when that little feller gets to where he's going, he won't be able to sit down for a week.
I should have bought a compass. I'm gonna miss all the fun. I just need some kind of sign. Huh. Now that is what I needed.
Even though everyone was really, really hungry and famished and starved, Jesus had fed all 5,000 with only 5 loaves and 2 fish. And there were even 12 baskets of leftovers. Think of having that much food around.
You're drooling, Libby.
Well, that was a miracle, so that's the end.
Speaking of miracles, look.
Woohoo! At long last. Talk about a needle in a haystack.
You said it, little buddy, and you were one tough needle to find.
Well, Fritz, I'm awfully glad you finally found us.
Me too.
Hey, old buddy, old pal, that reminds me, I got a knock-knock joke in your honor.
Yippee!
Knock-knock.
Who's there?
Pooch!
Pooch who?
Put your arms around me, you big lug!
Hey, Fritz, nice hat you got there.
Thanks. It fell off some crazy guy who almost ran over me.
Oh boy.
Has anybody seen my horse?
Hey, don't worry about it. He'll come back on his own.
Well, anybody seen my hat?
What hat?
Give me that. Sit down and join the fun.
Oh, please don't say sit and fun in the same sentence.
Well, buddy, seems you have a little hitch in your get-along.
You know, this never happened to Roy Rogers.
Hi, everybody!
Hi!
How you doing?
Hey, you guys didn't think I'd let you go west without me, did you? I found the sweetest cupcake of a horse, and she's giving me the greatest ride.
Have a seat, Gloria. Joshua's just about to tell his Bible story.
All right.
Okay, there was this big giant named Goliath. He was,
Philistine.
A Philistine. And he wanted a man to come fight him. But none of the grown-ups would. So David, who was small, like me, said to the king, "I'll fight him."
The day was dark and dreary in the shadow of that man. The giant stood a mile high with a saber in his hand. He magnified my weakness with his black and gloomy stare. The sweat fell like a waterfall from his braided locks of hair.
His tiny hands were shaking as he picked up five smooth stones. He loaded up his slingshot, and a chill ran through his bones.
He raised his face to heaven, and he prayed for strength and mind. He swung his arm around and hit him right between the eyes.
Pressure me to quit. Then a strong and fearless spirit starts to rustle up in me, and a power straight from heaven spurs me on to victory.
Story for the roundup.
Great, let's hear it.
It's called The Good Neighbor.
Once upon a time, a wealthy rancher from Abilene was on his way to buy some cattle when all of a sudden he was held up by a vicious gang of desperados.
Stick them up!
They took his money, his fancy coat, and his brand new boots.
I love those boots.
Well, he was lying there, half dead, by the side of the road, when the Reverend, oh so holy, passed by. He took one look and said, "Poor man, of course I can't stop and help. I'm in such a hurry. I've got to get to the church." So he passed along on the other side of the road.
Then along came a judge, high and mighty, the hangingest judge in the territory. He took one look and said, "Poor man, of course I can't stop and help. I'll get blood on my fine robe. Besides, there's a case waiting for my wisdom at court," and he passed on the other side of the road.
I'm doomed. If those two good guys won't help me, who will?
Then along came a real Mohican. He was riding on his horse when he noticed the man. He got off his horse, came over,
helped him up, brushed off his skin knees, bandaged all of his wounds, and even gave him a ride back to town. Thank you. You're a good neighbor. The end.
Hey, buddy, what's that funny-looking instrument you got in your hand?
Why, Bill, this here's a French harp, a harmonica. Every cowboy worth his salt has one of these stashed away in his saddlebag. Oh, it's great for campfires. It's great for the Wild West.
I guess tomorrow's our last day here.
Yep, it was a great trip. Time sure flies when you're having fun.
But you've only been here 10 minutes.
Oh, I know, but it only feels like 5.
I can hardly wait for our next adventure.
Well, whatever it is, I hope God will give me the strength to survive it.
He will, Miss Bestel. One thing I learned is that God will give us enough courage to do anything.
Courage, we don't need to be scared.
And I learned it's what's on the inside of a person that really counts.
And God will give us everything we really need, even food.
I tell y'all, the next horse I'm gonna ride, it's gonna be on a merry-go-round.
That'll be safe for everyone, buddy. For sure. Well, it's been great having you all out here. Have you all had a good time?
Yeah!
Yeah!
There's nothing like being out west in these beautiful, wide open spaces. Yeah, I've lived here a long time, and my people have seen a lot of changes. You know, some say the west has been settled, but I'm not so sure.
Many, many years ago, when travelers headed west to live their dreams, to work the land, to buy a place of rest. Through mountains high and deserts dry, they passed along our way. Courage was their weapon to meet the dangers of the day.
Some simply came for treasure, to find their pot of gold. Some set out to stake their claims through chilling rain and cold. The story ends, the West was won, but there's a second part. It's still a lost and barren land. When you're looking at the heart,
has the West been won, or has the battle just begun?
Will stranded souls be saved before the the setting of the sun.
Have the untamed hearts been settled? Has the time for peace yet come? Is it truth or fiction? Has the West been
won? Is there a piece of untamed where no one dares to go? And is it fertile soil where seeds of faith could grow?
Is there an unsung hero who would risk his life for these? Who'll talk about his Jesus to everyone he sees?
Has the West been won? Has the battle just begun?
Will stranded souls be saved before the setting of the sun?
Have the untamed hearts been settled? Has the time for peace yet?
Spread the message all across the land. Wherever someone needs a helping, healing hand, we can go the distance to the corners of the world.
We can take God's love to every boy.
Has the West been won?
Is it truth or fiction? Has the West
as you know, friends belong always together.